there's some American patrols coming this way. The commander's really fucking handsome.
Colonel, sir!
Hey, now!
Right behind those trees with all the leaves, they'll never see you. Perfect concealment.
That's the word on every man. Fire 3 rounds and anything looks suspicious to him.
On my signal.
Hey guys, what's up? Perfect 22 here, and today we're gonna do a two-piece. And what I mean is, I'm the gray man. I'm gonna show you 50 shades of gray today. I'm gonna be blending in with the woodline, fields, some urban areas with nothing but gray. Because everyone always talks about, oh, I wanna be the gray man, and shit hits the fan. And number two, we're gonna actually, at the very end, talk about that accident that just happened and what the difference in cover and concealment is. Because when you're getting shot at, no one ever says, take concealment. Hope you like this. Make sure you subscribe and share it with a veteran, okay? Take this video and send it over to a veteran and ask them what they think. Because the best way to stop this 22 veteran suicides a day isn't by doing 22 push-ups a day for 22 days. I'm not doing push-ups. I am a veteran. It's by working with your veterans. It's by doing the stuff the veterans used to do that they were good at when they weren't veterans, when they were active duty. In today's culture, getting ready, prepping, becoming a prepper. So instead of Mission 22, hope you like this episode of Prepper 22.
Cell. Damn, it's the rebel and the devil, and one of us is going to hell. I got the whole plate covered.
Nobody can understand that. Fuck them. I don't got fans. I only got hope. You know what I'm saying? If they ain't down with me, fuck them. I'm a thug life. Everybody know what kind of world it is. Everybody know what type of motherfuckers I'm born again. They don't want to be down with me. They don't want to see me win. They can all suck my dick. I'm trying to live.
This vice president, Dan Quayle, demanded that such music be removed from the record stores.
Putting out and distributing a record and making money off a record that says it's okay to kill cops. I find that outrageous.
Scream if you feel me. See it clearly. You're too near me. love it when they fear me. See it clearly, I live to hear me. Will I quit? Will I quit? They claim that I'm violent, but still I kick. Representing, never give up on the good thing. We'll stop it if we could, it's a hood thing. And now I'm like a major threat, cause I remind you of the things you were made to forget. Bring your noise to all my boys, come to real for the losses and the decodes. And if you hustle like a real G, put me this if you feel me, all in the hear me. Learn to survive in a non-truck. I make crime pay, others make crime pay. Whatever it takes to live and stand, cause nobody else will give a damn. So we live like caged beasts, waiting for the day like a rage freak. Steal me till they kill me. I love it when they fear me. Holler to hear me. Holler to hear me. Holler to hear me. Scream if you feel me. See it clear? You're too near me. Holler to hear me. You hustle like a real cheat. Put that fist in your feel me. Holler to hear me. Scream if you feel me. See it clear? You're too near me. Holler to hear me. Holler to hear me. You hustle like a real cheat.
So better get up on the day I die. You can bring your crew, but we remain true, motherfucker. You can bring your crew, but we remain true, and they got you.
I feel like Top Gun. I don't know about you guys watching this, but when I'm driving back home from a great training session at martial arts schools, or some awesome outdoors or tactical training, whatever, and I'm driving home and I'm all like sweaty and my hair's all fucked up and I'm like, I did it. You know, I feel like Top Gun flying my jet back. You know, I wish Top Gun had a radio station. But I had cut my video a little short. I wanted to get into some other scenery and terrains, but I couldn't because my wife called me. We're celebrating my youngest daughter's birthday today, and you know, because of that, kids are your best cards if you can get them inspired about it. Because she was up at the crack of dawn, just like me. It's about cover versus concealment. That's right. They have to be versus because they're different. And you will see, you'll run into both of them. Let me turn this radio down, it's a great song. You're gonna run into both. Let me ask you a question. This is a whole different video one day we should do. What's the difference in an ambush and a raid? And if you've ever been to Ranger school, you better know that. Okay, short term for all my Minutemen, my light fighters out there, raid is where, you know, the bad guys are sitting in the house, smoking the weed, watching the Pornhub, eating the pepperoni pizza, not expecting anything. Or maybe they got a little bit of guards, but they're sitting there and you, boom, pop into their yard, raid in, jump in, grab them, and go. Or stay there, but you jump into the yard to do it. An ambush is the opposite. It's where you're in their yard, or they're in your yard, that's not the point, but you are laid down, hunkered down, and now they're coming. And as they're coming, you're like, boom, bop, 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 and, you know, and then you break contact. So one, you're assaulting in, two, you're defending them possibly coming in, but they're not assaulting yet because you got them a little early. Think about that. When you come in or the bad guy comes into your defense position, You've got some guard posts set up, some OP posts set up, some walls. You've got the cover that you need. You built a castle in the dirt, in the woods. When they're sneaking up, the most they got is concealment. I mean, when they got bulletproof vests, that's the little bit of cover, but they got concealment. Like I said, when someone's getting shot at, no one ever says, hey, take concealment. They say, take cover. Cover will save your life in that danger. You know, it stops the bullets, these brick walls and sandbags. Concealment will just hide it, hide you, until the threat happens. And yeah, like we saw out there, I used some cool little We Were Soldier clips and shit, showed some commies getting shot up, you know, God bless them. But in your daily life, and I want you, this is my message for all my civilian light fighters out there, reach out to all my veterans and my veterans, think about this. Are you just concealing your problems in life, or do you actually have a cover? Because when we first get out of the Army, we're all alcoholics when we're in the Army. I mean, yeah, it happens. But when we first get out of the Army, we all use that alcohol or addiction, maybe drugs, whatever, to conceal those demons inside. But and we think it's covering it. Oh, I'm stressed out, but I drink this. I don't think about it. I go to sleep. Next morning, I wake up. I can work all day. You know, it's a bitter downward spiral because it's just concealing that problem, and eventually, that problem's gonna kill us. Same thing, you know, these little Viet Cong, Vietnamese, would conceal themselves by wearing solid gray bushes on them, trying to walk up. But guess what? That little bush is only a concealment. It's not covering them when they fight these brutes, barbaric, handsome American infantrymen, both Marines and Army, a couple of Navy guys got thrown out there too, I guess, who not only are okay with recon through fire and dropping bombs and burning the fuck out of shit, but we have the money to do it. We have the bombs. I got money to blow. So I want you to think today, I want you to think, am I just using a concealment for these problems in my regular daily life that are just gonna lead to my downfall and demise and death later? Or do I got some cover? And you need cover, whether it's reaching out to another battle buddy or reaching out to an outdoor enthusiast to go hiking or reaching out to a guns enthusiast to go shooting or going to a Milsim event or a paintball event or a Brazilian jiu-jitsu open mat or just, you need something to help you get that out. That's your cover. It ain't fucking working out 22 push-ups a day for 22 days and posting a hashtag mission 22.
Yeah.